we're all going to lose our parents and our siblings, right? Yeah. But to lose your partner, and there was no shake in our marriage. No one was unhappy. It
do
was.
You, do you see a future where you could find somebody to love again?
Yeah, I love love. I love to be. When you experience love and partnership the way I did, you crave it. You want it. Yeah. I mean, it's incredible. We built something together, and it was fucking magical. I married the most magical person I've ever met in my entire life. Mm-hmm. And it was such a gift. I mean, the gift that he gave me, he taught me, he showed me my self-worth. He showed me how to love myself. Like, I was none of those things before him. It was, so I love love. It's just going to be different now. It's because also, you know, people have asked me out recently. People got some people trying to shoot their shot. But the thing is, you know, the person that I'm going to date has to have the most compassion and empathy and be confident in who they are, because I'm never going to fall out of love with my husband. Like, I know I'm going to get married again and I will have a husband again, but I'll always love my other husband. I'll always celebrate his birthday and our wedding anniversary. You don't fall out of love with someone, you know, you don't fall out of love with your parents when they,
well, especially because it was like just ripped away.
He
like
was
it
was ripped. Not, we had a whole day. You know? He was a little sick for a few weeks before. We knew it. His ex-wife knew it. He was stubborn. He didn't go to the doctor, but it was, we just had a normal day. And then a massive heart attack, just a massive heart attack that happened in 20 seconds and he was gone. It was like the blink of an eye and everything changed. My whole life, everything. So I do want to love again. I love love. I love being in love. I love seeing my friends in love. I have a handful of friends right now that are super in love. You know, my siblings just got married. I couldn't make it to one of their weddings, which was, you know, devastating, but emotionally I wasn't strong enough. But,
well, I think a lot of people shy away from it. They'll be like, I'll never feel it again. But I think it's great that you're positive about it. And I would argue that hollowness, or it's like, it's kind of like, I use this example all the time, like a lake where all the water's been drained out. That means that you have the capacity to hold that much love in you.
Yes.
So that's beautiful.
Yes, that's right. Ooh, that just gave me the chills. That was good. I like that one. I do. That's the thing about this grief experience. There's no capacity. And, you know, it is a hollowness, but I hope that hollowness stays with me. That's how much I love him, that I want to honor that hollow space that can never be filled, but around that hollow space, I'm allowing love in, and I'm allowing myself. I gave myself permission to live again.
Good.
And it's hard to do. It's the hardest thing for a widow to give yourself permission to continue.
So if you're watching this live stream, shoot your shot, boys and girls. Yeah.
I do prefer over 200 pounds. Mm-hmm. Willing to take applications of 175 if it works out, but there is a weight requirement to ride this ride. Yeah. Mama likes the big boys. Mama likes the big boys.
Oh yeah, Kristen.